Okay, so now let's talk piriformis. So piriformis is basically going to be, and the other lateral rotators in your hip, it's going to be right back here. And you'll feel it because if you're going to work on it, it's going to get your attention pretty quickly as the sciatic nerve runs right through it sometimes. Different people, it runs in different spaces, but it's right in that general area. So you're going to want to be attentive when you're trying to stretch it, that you don't overdo it and agitate the nerve. So you can start, I usually do the softball, but you can start with the tennis ball if you need to. And you can start off with the easy way to release it with the ball, although I don't find that this is effective with everybody, but you can start as the easier way to go is you're just setting it right underneath, basically between the top of that femur and where the tailbone is. And all you're doing is just kind of moving your leg out and then back in. I don't feel that it always releases it for me, but I'm also used to the higher tension and the higher pressure. So I'll go with the softball, and then I put my leg almost in the half pigeon stretch. So that the half pigeon would be where my leg was crossed over like this. Now if you can't get your leg to that position, the stretch that goes before that would be working on getting into this half pigeon stretch. And so that might be holding right here and doing kind of a PIR or some other assisted stretching position where I usually do this sitting up. I'll show it later sitting up. But basically what I'm gonna do is, I'll show you on this side, is I'm gonna push my leg into extension for like 6 seconds and then I let it relax. And as I let it relax for 6 seconds, I'll pull up further. So if you can get to a normal range of motion with this half pigeon stretch, then you can go ahead and get into this deeper piriformis stretch. So I'm gonna put my, I'm gonna sit right on that right there, and I'm gonna cross this leg over, and then I bend this leg up, and that's it. Now, the less I help with my hands, the more it puts pressure on the piriformis. I kind of move around until I find the different spots. There's a couple of different spots, probably different lateral rotators that we're on. And you're just gonna stay there for as many deep breaths as you need to help it release. And then you can go back through that half pigeon stretch, and you can do it sitting up, but you can also do it from this position here. After I'm done with those stretches, really what I like to do is I just like to go through this position, going side to side. I start off with like a light range of motion, and then I gradually start pushing my knees closer to the ground until I get to the point where they actually are touching. And I'm opening up and it's letting that piriformis go on each side in order to make sure I get the full range of motion.